Pharaoh was afraid there were too many Hebrew people and they would try to fight the Egyptians. So he ordered all male Hebrew children born to be killed by the Egyptians, midwives or nurses.
When Moses was born, his mother Jochebed decided to try and save him. So she put him in a basket and placed it in the Nile River. She prayed he would be rescued.
In Exodus chapter 2, the Bible does not say the name of Jochebed as Moses' mother. Her name is found in the Torah of the Jewish written law, the first five books of the Hebrew Bible.
Genesis!
Exodus!
Leviticus!
Numbers!
Deuteronomy!
The Torah is also known in Judaism as
the Shemesh!
The Pentateuch!
And the five books of Moses!
The baby was saved by the daughter of Pharaoh who raised Moses as her own child.
All was going just fine for Moses until one day when he killed an Egyptian man who was beating a Hebrew. When Moses found out that Pharaoh was going to kill him, he left Egypt really quickly.
He ended up with the family of Jethro, the priest of Midian, and married his daughter Zipporah. Moses was very happy as a shepherd and content with his own life. But God had other plans for Moses.
And we all know what that means when God has other plans for you.
Moses!
Here I am!
I want to say who I am too!
Me too!
Me three!
I have heard the cries of the sons of Israel. Therefore, I will send you to Pharaoh so you may bring my people out of Egypt.
Who am I, God, to do this? I stutter and can't speak well.
I think Moses spelled speech 101.
Who has made man's mouth? Is it not I, the Lord? I will speak with your mouth and teach you what to say, and I will send your brother Aaron, the Levite. He speaks fluently.
Aaron must have made all things.
God gave Moses a staff that he would use to show God's miracle to Pharaoh.
Surely you must be crazy. Let my free workforce go right in the middle of my magnificent pyramid building. Leave!
You should know not to laugh at what God tells you to do.
I want to be Pharaoh! Here comes the plague!
Aaron threw down his staff and it became a serpent. But Pharaoh called his wise men and they threw down their staffs and they became serpents too. But Aaron's serpent ate all of theirs. Still, Pharaoh said no.
The next morning, Moses went to the river Nile where Pharaoh was.
Take your staff and stretch out your hand over the waters of Egypt, that they may become blood.
All the water in Egypt turned into blood, even the water in the pots and the half-pots. The fish in the river Nile died, but Pharaoh's magicians did the same, so his heart was hardened and he would not let the people go. The next morning, Moses went to the river Nile where Pharaoh was.
Take your staff and stretch out your hand over the waters of Egypt, that they may become blood.
Over water in Egypt turned into blood.
Real yucky. And everything is blood.
So his heart was hardened, he would not let people go.
Thus says the Lord, let my people go, that they may serve me. But if you refuse to let them go, behold, I will smite your land with frogs.
Smite means bang.
Bash!
Hit. Strike.
Nothing good.
Pharaoh's magicians Egyptians did the same, so his heart was hardened, and he said no to Moses and Aaron. So all the land and every house was covered in frogs. They jumped on all the people.
Frogs up. Pharaoh called
Moses and Aaron.
Frogs up.
Pharaoh called Moses and Aaron. The Lord told Moses to have Aaron hold out his staff and strike the dust of the earth that it would become gnats through all the land of Egypt.
And gnats were everywhere.
All on the ground.
On all the men and animals of Egypt.
This is the finger of God. Let these people go before we all die.
No.
The Lord says, let my people go, or I'll send swarms of insects on you, your servants, and all of Egypt. But they will not be in Goshen where my people live. Thus, you'll know that I, the Lord, am in the land.
There were insects of all kinds, everywhere, on everyone. Okay. Driving me crazy.
Okay. Take your people and do your sacrifice, but get rid of these insects.
God took away the insects, but Pharaoh hardened his heart again and still would not let the people go.
The Lord told Moses, tell Pharaoh that if he does not let the people go, he would become a really bad disease that would kill all the livestock in the field, the horses, the donkeys, the herds, and the flocks.
But Pharaoh's heart was hardened, and all of the livestock of the Egyptians died. God protected the livestock of the Hebrews and none of them died, but Pharaoh still would not let the people go.
Glad my owner's Jewish.
Me too.
God told Moses to take two cords, hemlock-like ashes from where a fire was burned and in the south of Pharaoh to throw the ashes in the sky. The ash fell on people and became bulls, even on the magicians of Pharaoh. But the heart of Pharaoh was hard again, and still he would not let the people go.
The next day, Pharaoh's new refused to let people go. He was told at the same time the next day, God was in a very heavy hail like no one had ever seen before in the land.
Thoughts of hail, thunder, and fire flashing from the sky. They killed anyone still in the field and destroyed the plants.
But in Goshen, where the Hebrews lived, there was no hail.
I have sinned this time. The Lord is the righteous one. I will let you go.
You think Pharaoh would cut on my man?
Thus says the Lord, the God of Hebrews, if you do not let the people go, tomorrow locusts will cover the land so that the ground is dark, and they will eat any plants that survive the hail. You thought all the plants were destroyed by the hail. Only the flax and barley were ruined. The wheat and spelt were not ruined because they ripened later. By the way, spelt is the type of whole wheat to make bread. Just in case you don't know what to buy next time at the store. Just thought you'd like to know.
Locusts covered the land and ate every green plant and tree.
Pharaoh called for Moses and said, you can take the men and hold a feast to your Lord. But when the locusts were swept by a west wind into the Red Sea, Pharaoh again hardened his heart and would not let the people go.
I know I'm as stubborn as an ox, but this guy, he's got me beat.
The Lord told Moses to stretch his hand to the sky, and there would become darkness over the land of Egypt. It was so dark people could not see each other, and they didn't move from where they were because they were afraid and could not see anything.
The darkness lasted for 3 days, but the Hebrew people had gotten their homes. Pharaoh again called to Moses.
Go serve the Lord. Just leave your flocks and herds.
We must take our livestock so we can make sacrifices to our Lord.
So Pharaoh's heart was again hardened.
Get away from me. Do not see my face again, or you shall die.
You're right. I shall never see your face again.
God told Moses to call all the Hebrew people together and said, thus says the Lord, about midnight, all the firstborn in the land of Egypt will die, and there will be a great cry in all the land. But against the sons of Israel, not even a dog will bark. Moses gave the Hebrew people instructions for the first Lord's Passover. They were to take a lamb with no blemish that was a year old and sacrifice it in a certain way. Look at Exodus chapter 12 and read all about it.
They were to take a bunch of pisin, which is herbs, and dip it into the
blood of the lamb and put it on the lintel sign. That's the top of the doorframe and doorpost of each Hebrew house. The death angel will pass over each of these homes, and all Hebrews are spared.
All of Egypt was weeping for their dead firstborn.
Pharaoh found Moses and Aaron.
Get out from among my people. Take your hurts, go and worship the Lord.
The Hebrew people had been in Egypt for 430 years, and there were a lot of them, about 600,000 men, not counting women and children.
God led them by the way of the wilderness to the Red Sea.
Now Pharaoh's heart was getting hard. This guy just doesn't know when to give up.
And people left Egypt, carrying all the possessions they could with them. As they approached the Red Sea, Pharaoh had changed his heart and ordered his army to bring them back.
When the Hebrew reached the Red Sea, they began to curse Moses because they did not see a way to cross the waters.
First they loved Moses, then they cursed him.
Do not fear. Stand by and see the salvation of the Lord.